Does EQ work properly? Of course it does. EQ's been around for a long time, and if it didn't do what it had been designed to do, then someone would have noticed by now. However, all of us try to use it for something it was never designed to do, which is to change the timbre of sounds. EQ was designed to correct problems at fixed frequencies, for example, a room mode or a peak in the response of a piece of equipment, and it's perfect for that. However, if you want to manipulate the timbre of a sound, EQ has got a shortcoming. Pitch sounds are made up of a series of harmonically related frequencies. This is what gives them their character or their timbre. In effect, all pitch sounds, apart from a sine wave, are a big chord, and the relative levels of the notes in that chord are what give the sound its timbre. If we boost an area of the spectrum using EQ, then we boost the level of a particular harmonic in a pitch sound. If we then play a different note, a different harmonic gets boosted. So the timbre of the two sounds isn't consistent between the two notes. That's the shortcoming of traditional fixed EQ, and that's what Surfer EQ addresses. So using Surfer EQ, I'm going to show you what the problem sounds like and how you can fix it. Filters which track keyboard control voltage have been around since the beginning of synthesis. I'm going to use a synthesizer in this example. You can see the fundamental and then the harmonics on top in that harmonic relationship. And if you keep an eye on that green spot, there it's over the third harmonic. If I play a G, now it still lines up with the harmonic, but it's a different one. It's the G. And if I play the octave, we can see it's in a gap. It's in a gap between the fundamental and the second harmonic. So using a static EQ, if I boost that third harmonic of that low C, or 194 Hz, we can hear what that sounds like. And hopefully you can really hear that's changed the timbre of that low C really dramatically. However, if I play that low G, it's boosting a different harmonic. And if I play that high C, there's no boost at all that we can hear. There's a timbral change depending on which note I play. This is where the pitch tracking capabilities of Surfer EQ come into their own, because if I switch that band over to surf, or to track the pitch, and to stay with the third harmonic, it'll listen to the incoming pitch. And if I play a different note, it'll find the third harmonic of that and boost that instead. And you can probably hear that we don't get a timbral change when we've got a surfing EQ band. To really show the difference between a static and a surfing band of EQ, I've got an example with a synth tone with some really wide vibrato on it. I've got a boost set up on the fundamental, and you'll hear that the fundamental passes below and then through and then out the other side of that band of EQ boost. Sounds like this. And you can hear that boost as it passes through. If I switch that band to surf on the fundamental of that note, we get a more consistent timbre. And you can hear how that band of EQ is tracking the pitch of the incoming note. Here's an example with a bass guitar. This low C has exactly the same harmonic series as the synth tone did. So it's got a C, another C, a G, a C, and an E above that. If I switch this in, I can boost, let's say, the third harmonic. That'd be this note here, the G. If I play notes other than C, I no longer have the third harmonic boosted. So if I play a D, I'm kind of nowhere, I'm in a gap. If I switch this to track, I can boost the third harmonic on every note I play. That hasn't even begun to scratch the surface of what you can do with Surfer EQ, but those examples illustrate what it is that's unique about Surfer EQ. If you're performing corrective EQ, then conventional EQ, static EQ, is exactly the tool that you want, and Surfer EQ does that too. But if you're using EQ to shape the timbre of your instrument and you want that change to be consistent as you play that instrument, then Surfer EQ's the only tool that can do that.